This video explains how to reproduce and fix the error message "error in setwd cannot change working directory" in the R programming language. So without much talk, let's dive into the R code. Let's assume that we want to change the working directory within RStudio. Then we might apply the setwd function, as you can see in line 3 of the code. And within the setwd function, we have to specify the path to the folder which we want to use as a working directory. So in this case, I want to specify the path to the desktop of my computer. And on the desktop of my computer, there should be a folder which is called some folder. And this folder should be used as a new working directory. However, when I run line 3 of the code, you can see that at the bottom in the RStudio console, the error message "error in setwd cannot change working directory" is appearing. And the reason for that is that on my desktop, I do not have a folder which is called some folder. You can see that by having a look at my desktop. So as you can see, currently there's no folder called some folder available, and for that reason the working directory cannot be changed. So we have basically two options to solve this problem. The first option is that we use a different path, as I show you in line 5 of the code. So in this case, I set the working directory to be directly on the desktop of my computer. So after running line 5 of the code, our working directory is changed and we don't see any error messages anymore. However, in our specific case, we want to set the working directory to a new folder which is on the desktop of my computer and which is called some folder. And for this, we first need to create this folder. So as you can see, I create a new folder and I call this folder some folder. And now if we run the setwd function once again, as you can see in line 7 of the code, you can see that no error messages are appearing anymore. And now our working directory is set to our new folder, which is called some folder. That's all I wanted to explain in this video. In case you want to learn more on this topic, you may check out my homepage, statisticsglobe.com, because on my homepage I have recently published a tutorial in which I'm explaining the content of this video in some more detail. I will put a link to this tutorial into the description of the video so you can find it there. If you have liked this video or if you have any questions, let me know in the comments section below. I'll try to respond to all comments as soon as I can. Furthermore, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get notified about future video releases. I have already published about 500 videos on this channel and I'm releasing new videos on a daily basis. Thanks a lot for watching. See you in the next video.